business, then?
Only me, sir.
What's anybody been up to at the keyhole, eh?
I don't mean no harm, sir. Oh. You're so lonely downstairs. Please don't tell on me. Please don't.
You mean to say you were looking through the keyhole for company?
Yes, sir.
Well, well, well. How long have you been cooling your eye there?
Well, ever since you first began to play them cards. And a bit before. Hello, sir.
Hello yourself. Well, now you're in, you'd better stay.
You're the clerk that's come.
Written Swiveller, yours to command.
I'm the servant.
Are you indeed? You're a very small servant.
Well, not too small to do the cooking. I'm the housemaid too. Nor too small for that neither. She locks up the meat, you know.
The devil she does.
Keep away from that leg of mutton or you'll be picking it, is what she says. Do you see this, she says, holding out a square inch of beef on the end of a fork? Would I never go and say that you hasn't had meat here? And then she says, do I want more? And of course I says no, being terrified out of me skin. Very well, she says. You've been out once to meat, you've had as much as you can eat, you've been asked if you want more and your answer's no, so don't ever go and say that you was a lance, dear. Mind that.
She a dragon, is she?
She is a dragon. Just what she is, a dragon, sir.
Or something in the mermaid line, do you think? She's certainly scaly.
Dragon, sir?
Oh. Wouldn't have a quencher, I dare say.
Quencher, sir?
What about a glass of wine?
Well, there's wine in the larder, sir.
No place for it. Two glasses and a bottle, and I'll teach you cards.
Oh, sir. I've never.
Of course you would if you put your mind to it.